it! Somebody!
This doesn't make sense.
Please!
What does?
Call backup!
These orders.
What are we doing here when we should be part of the team bagging the primary objective?
Well, if I know.
Whoa!
Sam, we have an opportunity here. Reed stashed Vice President Samson in the ballroom with personal bodyguards. He's waiting to be introduced as the next president.
That's on my route to the West Wing.
Pay him a visit, then meet me in the press room. We'll figure out how to tackle Reed there.
Kills confirmed. No survivors. Do a sweep for strikers. Number six.
Kill search!
Target class crash.
To continue. The unending search for justice within our own.
Yeah, sit and guard here.
We got a man down. Everybody!
Lost our contract in the dining room!
No contact! No contact!
This looks bad. Everyone hold position. The area ahead is a no-go. I'm holding. Likely ambush site ahead. I'm holding position here. The area ahead is not secure. I'm holding.
I see.
What the hell was Reed thinking? What happens to his special plan if I catch a stray bullet?
Mr. Vice President,
that's my fuck!
Shot. Kill him!
Bring it on, asshole!
I scraped pig shit off my shoes. It was smarter than you, Fisher. You piece of shit. I'll have you killed. You hear me? Kill!
Run.
Come on. You don't get it, do you? You can't touch me. I got protection. I'm Teflon. So whatever you think you're gonna do to me, Mr. Has-been, Mr. Rogue Agent, Mr. Washed-up Spy, we can forget about it right now, because I'm bulletproof. Goddamn bulletproof, you hear?
Oh, really?
Me. Ah!
You know, you need to work on that whole bulletproof thing.
Bitch! Ah! Oh, God, it hurts! Ah!
Take cover! Look out! We're the...
By the time Grimm got a hold of Sam, Reed's men were kicking in the Oval Office door. She was there, and she could see that the president's protective detail was going down. The plan was for Sam to meet with Grimm in the press room where they'd figure out what the hell to do next. Of course, Grimm already had a plan, one she hadn't bothered to tell Sam about. But that shouldn't have surprised him. Some things, and some people, just don't change.
Fisher comes through here, he's gonna get hit by so many rounds, it's gonna turn real soon.
Requesting backup at my local.
Oh, shit!
happened, asshole? This fucker's dead. The target's still close by. Spread out and find him.
No sign of him. He's gotta be here somewhere.
Still no visual on the target.
Our generation.
Watch your back. Close. Really close.
Has been called on.
Contact! Did not get him!
Sometimes you just have to do things the hard way.
You're not getting through here. You're history, Fisher. Stay high to Lambert for me.
We're out of time, Sam. Where are you?
I'm close.
Get closer. Reed's knocking on the door to the Oval Office right now. Whatever it's worth, Sam, I am so sorry for everything.
I thought we were in a hurry.
Right. We need to get you close to Reed, and we need to do it in a way that doesn't make him double-tap the president immediately.
Got any ideas?
One. But it's gonna hurt.
Just do what you have to do.
I always do, Sam. I always do. Tom? I've got Fisher. I'm bringing him in. Don't do anything drastic until I get there. Sorry, Sam. You're going to the Oval Office. You've got to dress properly for the occasion. Hands? You comfortable?
Ah, fuck.
Get up. You got an appointment with the president.
All those years you were lying to me.
It was for the greater good, Sam. And I would do it again in a heartbeat, for the same reasons.
Guess I never did know you.
No, you didn't. And you still don't.
I was wondering when you were gonna get here. Nice work, Anna. I see you got some payback in for the stunt he pulled at the airfield.
Well, he put up a little bit of a fight.
Of course he did. And now he's here, the famous Sam Fisher, just in time to be useful. So how does it feel, Sam, knowing you're gonna go down in history as the man who assassinated President Caldwell?
Fuck you, Reed.
Of course, we'll be just a little too late to rescue her. And you'll be shot multiple times trying to escape. It's classic, but it's clean.
You don't honestly believe that this is gonna work. The surveillance camera's footage is gonna show.
Your cameras, we own them. Your security measures, we made sure the Pulse fried them. We're third echelon, Madam President. We own every bit of information that goes through this town. And if I want to, I can make it look like you were assassinated by two circus clowns and a golden retriever. So shut up, and you might live a few seconds longer.
That's not third echelon.
It's not Lambert's third echelon. Last time I checked, he was dead. And guess what? Third echelon nearly died with
him. Tom.
You see, the president decided the agency wasn't justifying its funding anymore. She was gonna shut us down, leave America vulnerable to the sort of attacks you spent so many years stopping, Sam.
That's not what...
You had plenty of chances to talk, ma'am. Megiddo was willing to play ball and you weren't, so this is on you. And yes, it is really that simple. Caldwell's policies didn't match Megiddo's. Caldwell's gotta go.
So you set off your EMPs, murder a city, and assassinate the president instead.
Yes, it's a hard decision, but the right one. A wake-up call to the country. Proof that it can happen at any time, to anyone. A reminder that we need to be vigilant at every moment, that we need third echelon to keep us safe.
Madam President, are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine, thank you.
Son of a...
That was a close call.
You've got maybe 2 minutes before the army takes back the White House. Make them useful. How did Megiddo get to you?
You don't want to know about Megiddo, you want to know about your daughter.
You don't get to talk about my daughter.
Still don't get it, do you? Sarah didn't matter. Threatening her was just a way to get to you. And leveraging you was a way to get to third echelon. And third echelon, that was a way to get what they wanted out of the White House.
You're the mole. You're the one Lambert was worried about.
Very good, Sam. You finally see.
You son of a bitch! You cost me 3 years of my life. 3 years when I thought my daughter was dead. Move! Move!
Drop your weapon on the floor now!
Captain, thank you for rescuing me. Now, I don't see anyone else here but us, and I'm sure you don't either.
Oh, ma'am. Let's get you out of here.
Thank you.
Oval Office is secure. We have the president. POTUS is safe and secure.
Are you gonna testify my trial? I could use a good character witness.
You already had your trial.
You didn't have to do that.
I disagree.
There was a time where you wouldn't have said that.
Things change, Sam.
Yeah, things change. Remember what you told me, Anna. When this was over, everybody walks. I'm walking.
You can't. There's too much left to do.
Ask Lambert. I've done too much already.
Sam, please. I don't know who else I can trust.
Trust? Funny you should say that. Goodbye, Grim.
I've talked to Sam once since he left. He told me that he and Sarah were going to take some time to catch up. He talked about learning who was really important to you, why you always had to come back for him. He talked about family. And you know what the last thing he said to me was just before he hung up? Vicky said, "Thanks for everything. I love you like a brother." Brother. That's family, right? Yeah. I thought so.
Thank you. He's leaving out the part where you're headed in the country to Miramar.
Well, yeah, but that was later. All we did there was take out the third rank of the general in the group, Hunter, and prevent a cross-border incursion into Laos.
At King Lap.
Right, right, King Lap. The river crossing. Biggest damn catfish I've ever seen. Details. The important stuff is what happened in Kaya.
You have to tell the story every damn time.
Every chance I get. Anyway, we're in this bar pretending to be tourists. When this guy comes up to us, worst job of reading people I've ever seen in my life. Because he figured Sam was a sucker.
Most people do. He lived. That makes him unique.
Yeah, yeah, whatever. So, this guy, he walks up to Sam, sizes him up, and asks him if he wants to buy an elephant.
A full-grown elephant.
Yeah, like, that makes a difference. The guy tries to sell Sam an elephant. And Sam here, he's got this look on his face like he doesn't know what to do. First time I've ever seen him like that.
I was trying to figure out how to tell Sarah that she couldn't have an elephant.
So Sam finally turns to him and says, sorry, I already got one. Cool as ice, just like that. And the guy, he believes him.
It was either that or break his arm. I like to think I made the right decision.
Thank you.